Welcome to Research Technique Series.
Today we are going to talk about T-pair test. Usually T-tests are used in most of the hypothesis testing. T-test is also used in one sample T-test to observe whether variable or statement is significant or not. Two independent sample tests to observe whether these samples have difference in means or not. Two dependent samples as paired to observe whether there is any difference in means for paired observations. Today we will discuss T-paired test. T-paired test is used in biostatistics, medicines, operations, HR, education. When some treatment is given in the form of certain medicines or in the form of certain other training or some surgery or some other things. So we have to see whether the changes are due to this medicine or not, or due to this operations. Now, in management, machineries are overhauled, whether the production has increased or not, whether there is any effect of overhauling or not. HR, human resource management, people give training, people give incentives, bonuses to the people, whether it has really worked or not. There are motivational lectures, whether these with motivational lectures, whether there are changes or not. In education, we teach the students, we observe what happened before and after that, the treatment after the education. Experiment research is one of the best research designed to innovate something. Experiment is a small intervention to observe changes in output. Now, this intervention should not be so big to stop the process and not so small to make any difference. Intervention can be in the form of small changes in inputs or environment like temperature, treatments, operation, surgery, etc. Experiments, the sample size should not be so small. It is expected to be 30 or more, but sometimes in labs we cannot get more samples, but 25-30 is okay. Better if control groups are used with this, so you can compare the observations post, pre-post observation and with the control group, whether there are any changes or not. T-pair test should not be used for historical data, it is my opinion, as time series may have trends in the form of time or lagged momentum. T-pair test should be avoided if experiment takes a longer time, then control group and other measures should be used to observe historical impacts or self-learning or self-treatment of the observants. Let us learn T-pair test manually on Excel and then using data analysis technique in Excel. We will frame the hypothesis and test the hypothesis. My forthcoming videos will explain history of experimental research, degree of freedom, p-values. So you can remain in touch with this platform by subscribing or pressing bell button. We have taken an example where there are 12 observations. We have taken the pre-test, that is before the treatment. We have taken the observations 10, 9, 11, 10, 8, 7, 6, 9, 10, 12, 10, 11. Post-test 12, 8, 13, 12, 13, 8, 8, 12, 11, 15, 12, 13. Now these are not independent observations. Each observation depends upon the other observation same level. For instance, for respondent number 1, earlier value before the treatment was 10 and after the treatment it is 12. For second respondent, the pre-test, the before treatment it is 9 and after the treatment it is 8. If you don't want to write pre-test or post-test, you can write it here before and after. Now, after observations, they are dependent on the first observations, that is before observation. You can write here as before or after. Before and after. Now first we will do this T-pair test manually. Let us find the difference. Now in this case, difference of each observation. So first observation, we have taken the value as C3, 12, minus your B3, that is difference between the first observation. Now we have just, we will drag it, it will give me the values of differences. Now after, before, what was the difference before and what was the difference? So we have taken the difference of the two. Now we will find out, we have to find out the t-stat. First our thing is, first of all we will find out the mean equal to the average this will give us the mean of the differences. Now we can have two sets of hypotheses here. I'll say three sets of hypotheses. The first one is, let us say the first set, we can have it. You can have either of the three. Let us say set one. Null hypothesis is there is no difference. Means D is equal to zero. Meaning D is equal to 0. So this is our null hypothesis. Alternate hypothesis can be written as there is a difference. Now this difference can be any side. It can be greater than 0 or it can be less than 0, but here the hypothesis, test of hypothesis is, meaning D is not equal to 0. Now second can be one tail, second set can be one tail. One tail can be null hypothesis there is no difference. Now this is one tail, meaning D is equal to 0. Alternate hypothesis can be there is an increase in value, in mean, because we are basically testing the mean. So we can say D is greater than 0. Now the third set, this we can make it as second set, and this we can make it as third set. So where again this is going to be one tail, this is going to be one tail test, so we can say there is no difference. That is, meaning D is equal to zero. And alternate hypothesis, here we can write down null hypothesis and alternate hypothesis so that there is no confusion. And here also we can write down here alternate hypothesis, there is decrease in mean. That is, D is less than zero. So these are the three. Now you can write down any of the three sets, whichever you want it, whatever you feel it. So if you feel it that there can be increase or decrease, any side it can happen. So that will be a two tail test, which will be set one. If it is increase, then you can make it set two. If you feel it that there is going to be decrease, you can say it is set three. So these are the three separate. You can make the sets separate sets. There is no need to make all the sets. You can make whatever set you want to make it. Now after finding the mean, then we will find out standard deviation. Now standard deviation is, because this we are going to, usually we use samples, so we will use standard deviation of sample. Now simple meaning is, when we are taking the sample, we usually this divides by n minus 1. So this formula for standard deviation is x minus x bar, sigma x minus x bar whole square divided by n minus 1 under root. So that, next we have to find out standard error, because we are using standard, we are using sample, so we will use standard error. Now standard error, next we have to find out standard error, because we are using standard, we are using sample, so we will use standard error. Now standard error will be equal to standard deviation divided by under root n, that is 12 raised to power 0.5. So you are going to get this. Now we are going to find out t-stat. T-stat means x minus mu upon standard error. Now mu is hypothesized mean, that is zero. So we are going to get it x minus 0 upon standard error. So this is our x, that is mean, divided by standard error. So this gives us the t-stat value. Now here we have to find out the critical values now, because we have to compare it with the critical values. So critical values with the one tail and two tail, I am going to take both as 5% value. So critical value as 5%, if we take it up, so we can find the critical value equal to t dot inverse, probability is 0.05, 11 degrees of freedom, because 11 degrees of freedom is this, but now this is on the left side because it is giving us the negative value. And we can also find the critical value, positive critical value, so where you can write on the minus sign before that. So t dot inverse 0.05, 11 degrees of freedom. We are going to talk in another video. I have already told you what is the meaning of degree of freedom, why we are taking 11 degrees of freedom, and this is giving us the positive value. Now if it is, if we are to use the two tail, actually in two tail 5% should be divided into 2, 0.05 should be divided into 2, 0.025, but here I am going to take, for the sake of convenience, I am going to take it at 5% significance value. So it will be t dot inverse dot 2t into probability is 0.05. For the sake of convenience, we are going to take 5%. Actually, you should have taken it as 0.025%. So this is giving me this. Now we can compare this. If it is set number 1, if it is set number 1, that is, we are going to see there is a difference. D is not equal to 0. It can be on the left side also, it can be on the right side also. Anything. We have not decided anything. So set 1, but our calculated T value as calculated T stat is more than critical value. Reject H0, accept H1, which means there is a difference. D is not equal to 0, which means there is a difference. Now, second set, set number 2, if you want to take it up, increase value, there is no question of decrease here because mean is coming positive, t stats is positive, everything is positive. So as calculated value, t stat is more than critical value. Now which critical value? 1.795, because we are going to take it up now. 795885, and now as we have taken it up, now as a one tail test. So one tail test, but set number 2. And set number 3 has no meaning because it's all coming as positive. So, as calculated T stat is more than critical value, so accept H1, which means there is increase in the mean. Now, if you do not want to calculate manually, so you can use data analysis. You can use this data analysis, find out T paired to sample for means from this table, T paired to sample means, say okay, and fill up this value post test, and then range number 2 is pre-test, and then say, because you are using the labels also, so label says there hypothesized mean is 0, so I am going to put this output here somewhere so that there should not be any problem. On the second sheet I am not going to put it up. So these are now in this, see, it has calculated. You need not calculate anything manually. It calculates the mean for post-test, pre-test. It calculates the variances for the post-test and pre-test. Of number of observations are 12, but degree of freedom are 11. We are losing 1 degree of freedom. So there is it also calculates the Pearson's correlation. So it's a good correlation. So t stat is 4.89897948. Now in one tail, p value, it calculates the p value from the significance value. Now it is less than 0.05, so we can say, because the critical value is 1.795, you need not calculate it, also calculates for you. Similarly, two-tail critical tail value is also calculated. In both the cases, you can decide about the hypothesis. If it is one tail, so in one tail, value, p value is less than 0.05, so you reject H0, accept H1. Similarly, two tail also, p value is less than 0.05, so in that you can reject H0, accept H1. So you can see the p values, or you can simply compare the with the critical values it also gives you. So this is the way you can do the t-pair test. I am again telling that I will talk about experimental research again on some other video. I will again talk about the p-values in some other video. I will talk about one tail test and two tail test again on some other video. But this hypothesis should be properly understood, and then how the hypothesis, null hypothesis are rejected and as alternate hypothesis are rejected. So you can use this t-pair test in biostatistics, in medical, you can use this in HR, you can use this in any operations, machinery. I have given you the example of machinery. You maintain the machinery, give oil and maintain it and see the production before and after. But this should not be used for historical data.
Please note each research problem, whether medical, engineering, natural sciences, social sciences, including economical, human behavior, and psychological. They are all unique in nature. Each problem needs to be handled and analyzed with specific methodology. Each technique which I am going to take is general in nature and should be used under expert advice if you are a beginner. Learn the techniques and use your expertise specific to your problem wherever required. Happy learning! You may submit your research work at Journal of Global Economy, rcssindia.org. Your work is evaluated by peers with double-blind methodology. You will get comments for your work. Thank you.